Howdy, how's it going? My name's Davvy Chappy, and it's time to swoon all the boys and girls in the kingdom, make them feel special, and then steal their lunch money, because we're going to be talking about the Enchantment School of Magic. I'm going to go over every spell in the school, and I'm going to rate them on Davvy's Davvy Meter. As always, keep in mind that a lot of this is just my opinion, so if you feel that I'm not charming enough, go fuck yourself. But also feel free to use whatever enchantment spells that you want. But with that out of the way, let's begin. So, the Enchantment School of Magic is by far my favorite school in the entire game, just because, like the Illusion School, which is my second favorite, it focuses on solving problems without just throwing numbers at a wall and calling it a day. With the power of enchantment spells, you gain an upper hand in social encounters, and you can oftentimes create social encounters where you would normally never get a chance to, which means more role-playing and more of what D&D is known for. So if you're looking for a school that's all flash and no pizzazz, then you better go looking elsewhere, because it's time to delve into the enchantment school, starting with
cantrips!
Friends, it's a real duct tape and glue solution to social problems, but it gets the job done. Vicious Mockery. 1d4 obviously isn't all that jazz, but giving disadvantage on the next attack is always good, and this is your best chance to insult whatever bad guy you're attacking.
First level!
Animal Friendship. You never know when you're gonna need to befriend an angry squirrel. Bane. I know it's not much, but 1d4 can really make all the difference. Bless. Same as Bane. Charm Person. It's like Friends, only the target doesn't necessarily hate you after. Command. And here is your first taste of just dominating someone else's mind for your own purposes. Enjoy enchantments, kid. Compel Duel. Ignore the spell's intended purpose as a 1v1 fight because neither your friends nor your enemy's friends will respect it. Instead, it's better to use it as a tether to keep the bad guys from escaping. Dissonant Whispers. Good damage, and it forces people to get the fuck away from you, which, as a caster, is awesome. Heroism.
I need a hero. I'm holding out for a hero till the end of the night.
Hex, even if you're not a caster, taking the Magic Initiate feat just to get this spell is completely worth it. Sleep. At early levels, this spell will drop even bosses. At mid to late levels, it might take down a couple adds if you're lucky. Tasha's Hideous Laughter. You basically get to temporarily remove someone from the fight, but remember that knocking them prone makes them really susceptible to a dirty melee.
Second level!
Animal Messenger. Every time I see the spell, it reminds me of the rabbit scene from Season 3 of The Magicians. Go watch it, it'll make your day better. Calm Emotions. It really doesn't help turn a fight into a nice chat over tea, but it's great at removing mental debuffs on your friends in a pinch. Crown of Madness. So the problem with this spell is that you have to force the target to attack, or it gets its entire turn like normal, so they'll almost certainly just move out of range of their allies after the first hit. Plus, it uses your action each turn to maintain it, so... Enthrall. It's a spooky spell, useful if you want everyone to focus on you specifically. Hold Person. Paralyze is the most powerful condition in the game. You cast this on one person, and that person is effectively dead because they just became a crit magnet. Suggestion. You get your very own sleeper agent, or you get 8 hours of whatever you can think of. This spell is great and only gets greater with a little imagination. Zone of Truth. It makes it far easier to interrogate people, but a little bit of casual waterboarding will go just as far.
Third level!
Catnap. This spell is useless unless you happen to be in a party of literally only 3 people, and you also for some reason have a place to rest that doesn't work for 1 hour, but does still work for 10 full minutes. Sure, you can use a higher level spell slot to make it work on more people, but then it becomes even more of a hindrance on your spell economy. Enemies abound. I mean, it's okay, but that spell isn't going to last long once the target starts getting whacked back for being a dick.
Fourth level!
Charm Monster. It's like Charm Person, but better. Compulsion. Come to me. Now go away. Okay, now come to me. Now go away! This spell's fun. Dominate Beast. Very specific, which prevents it from getting that third Davvy head, but hey, if you see a dinosaur, that boy is yours.
Fifth level!
Dominate Person. Now this is the charm you want. Be the enchanter you were always meant to be. Gyas. 5d10 is good for fifth level, but once they trigger it, that Gyas may as well not exist for the rest of the day. That being said, the spell lasting for 30 days can still give you an unwilling ally if they're not particularly strong. Hold Monster. It's like Hold Person, but better. Modify Memory. It's very good for roleplaying, and I like that you can specifically modify their memory to make the memory completely clear to them. Synaptic Static. Drop a debuff that does fireball damage and a better Bane to boot. Fifth level is a little steep, but it's still a good time.
Sixth level!
Mass Suggestion. It's like normal suggestion, but way better. Otto's Irresistible Dance. This spell is not terrible. Please note that it does not force a save, it just forces you to dance. Instant gratification as they gyrate those hips.
Seventh level!
Power Word Pain. Amazing for when you need to torture someone without hurting them. Otherwise, enjoy your crappy Crucio, kiddo.
Eighth level!
Antipathy. /sympathy. Either keep someone away from something or bring them in close. Either way, this spell is the strangest crowd control that I've ever seen. Dominate Monster. It's like Dominate Person, but sorry, boss monster, I own your ass now. Feeble Mind. This spell lasts for 30 days, and it gives you the stats necessary to enjoy your average episode of Davvy Chappy. Power Word Stun. My problem with this spell is that while it is an automatic stun for anyone with 150 HP or less, it's also an 8th level spell that is about as effective as Hold Person after the first turn. Hell, even Paralyze is a stronger condition than Stun. done, so I can't in good faith recommend this spell.
Ninth level!
Power word kill. Even if you can't kill it right away, you're still effectively removing 100 health from the battle with the final boss, because as soon as they fall below 100 health, all you have to do is lean in close and say,
Maiwa.
Psychic scream.
You freaking freaks! Where will you learn that your actions have consequences?!
But that'll about do it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like and comment if you did. Subscribe if you want to be a cool dude. And maybe support me on Patreon so that I can slowly make my entire life revolve around D&D. Also, if you want to stay up to date on all of your Davvy news, I keep a link to my social media in the description below. But yeah, Davvy out.